people appoint a government to govern the country. Amongst the key responsibilities of a government, one of the primary responsibilities is managing the economy. But if you look at the way this government is managing the economy, I don't think any citizen can be satisfied with that performance. Just look at the statistics. The growth rate, which was more than 7% just a couple of years ago, has come below 4%. The cost of living has gone up, and the inflation, which was 3.3% in 2014, is now about 8.6%. The national debt has gone up by more than 32%. It was rupees 7,391 billion in 2014. By June 2017, it had gone up to 10.1 trillion, huge increase in national debt. The exports have come down. The loss due to the drop of exports during the last 2 years is about US dollar million, 1,600 plus. The investors are pulling money out of the country. More than US dollar million 1,400 has been taken out of the country during the last 2 years. Bloomberg has now rated Sri Lanka as one of the dangerous countries to invest. The three reputed rating agencies, Fitch, Moody's and S&P, all three have downgraded Sri Lanka's rating. So all in all, Sri Lanka's economy is in a crisis. There's no doubt about it. So the responsibility of the government should be now to identify this problem and address those, because that is one of their primary responsibilities. But what is the government doing? They are currently acting as if introducing a new constitution as their main responsibilities. But who has given them a mandate for that? Nobody in this government, the ruling parties, have a mandate for that. Just look at the president. The president's election manifesto very categorically said that he will introduce only amendments to the constitution, and all those amendments will be those which do not require a referendum. So if we go for a new constitution, that will definitely require a new referendum. So it is outside the mandate of the president. So he has no mandate for a new constitution. Then if you look at the MPs in the parliament who have got elected through UPFA and currently with the president, they also don't have the mandate, because they came to the election under the manifesto which didn't say anything about a new constitution. Anagatita Sahatekia didn't say anything about new constitution. So if you look at the UNP, they were the only people who spoke about a new constitution in their manifesto, but they also didn't get a mandate because they got only 45.6% of the valid votes. They won only 106 seats in the parliament out of 225. So they even didn't get the simple majority that is required to rule the country. So nobody in this government has a mandate to introduce a new constitution. So then the question is, why is government so gung-ho about introducing a new constitution? That is simply because they are doing a contract. They are performing as per the expectations of somebody who supported them to come to power. So we request the government now, stop doing this, stop fooling the people. Please work according to the mandate that is given to you. Please start governing the country, start solving the problem. Put this economy back on track. That is your primary task.